10 मिलियन भी जुड़ जाए एंड एड से $1 a day, $1 a day, यू कैन इमेजिन हाउ मच मनी कॉर्पस यू कैन हैव टू स्ट्रेंथन इंडियन. यू कैन वर्क ऑन एजुकेशन, यू कैन वर्क ऑन हेल्थ, यू कैन डू दिस काइंड ऑफ एन ऑल वर्ल्ड वाइड. नॉन रेजिडेंट इंडियन आर द बिगेस्ट मनी सेंटर आफ्टर चाइना. चाइना इनफैक्ट यू हैव एक्सीडेड चाइना. Indians in UAE and the Gulf are the biggest money centers after beyond before China. You are already a gold mine for the world. You need to connect together. Once you connect together, then you act as a pressure group saying, we want voting rights. And the day you as non-resident get voting rights, government of India will start delivering better. Because you are linking your foreign exchange oxygen to performance, right? Yes. You can do it. So instead, while you are small groups by your region, by your language, by your culture, but as non-resident Indians, worldwide, you need to come together as a body and even donate to a corpus called the India Support Corpus or India Prosperous Corpus and create a corpus of $1 a day. That means you can save $23 million a day. A day. I say do it even once a month. $23 million a month. You can open up polytechnics. You can open up dispensaries. You can open up institutions and colleges, right? You can open up so many things by those. This is what the power of the non-resident Indian is. I've always been saying this. Unless you do that, you will not become a pressure group. First unite externally, then have funding power with you, then strengthen causes. And I would say, if you want to pick up any part of India to strengthen, pick up, start with Uttar Pradesh. Why Uttar Pradesh? Because India, Uttar Pradesh is the only state which is actually holding us back. I'm just again frankly saying it, I do not know if anybody belongs to Uttar Pradesh, but it is holding you back by poverty, by infrastructure, by unemployment, by migration of its youth going to Gujarat, going to Maharashtra and elsewhere, and Punjab to work. Why? Because they don't have employment. Bad roads, no electricity, even corruption very rampant in poor police. This is the Uttar Pradesh of today. And if Uttar Pradesh was a country by itself, it would have been the seventh largest country in the world in numbers and size after Australia, Canada, Indonesia, India and Brazil. These are India's UP would have been. So as non-resident Indians, come together, get the financial muscle, then ask for voting rights, pick up one state and settle it down. The day Uttar Pradesh is moved out of poverty, India will change. Because Madhya Pradesh has changed. Rajasthan has changed. You see, they were part of Bimaru states. They were called Bimaru states. Bihar is changing. It's slow. But in that Bimaru state, Uttar Pradesh is very, very vital. Others have moved out of Bihar. They started to develop because of better political governance, if you ask me. Nitish Kumar started the change, right? Chhattisgarh has shown the change. Rajasthan has shown the change, but not the best. So I think if we can all work together, and as non-resident Indians, focus on Uttar Pradesh, India will change.